What's up, everybody? I'm Robbie. Welcome to the channel. And today we're going to talk about the Elgato Stream Deck, why to get it, how to set it up, and how to make your life more simple. Cue the unnecessary intro. If you're not familiar with the Elgato Stream Deck, the Stream Deck is designed for content creators and streamers to easily control their lights, their streaming software, as well as other programs. The model I'm using comes with 15 standard programmable buttons, and then that can be expanded to different profiles and different pages within those profiles to basically make it unlimited use of how you would like. I've been playing around with this since Christmas, and honestly, now I'll take my laptop and not have it plugged in, and I don't want to not use it. So even if you're not techie, it's very simple to set up. So I want to show you that. So let's get this set up. All right. So I'm at my desk right now, and I'm going to show you and walk you through how to set this up and hopefully make it pretty simple for you. But first things first, let me just show you the setup I have going. Jump over here. So you can run through different pages of programs you'd use and even shortcut keys of what you would find the most beneficial for you and set it up however you want on it. So it's going to give you a lot of customization for this. And so the way I have this set up is I have my desk lights. I can turn those on and off, and that's going to trigger because they're plugged into an Alexa plug. And I can turn those on and off. My ambient lights will be behind me. I can turn on and off my studio light or turn it back on. From our program, we're going to download the Elgato Stream Deck software, and that's going to look like this. And so you're going to create an account. You're going to then from there assign that Stream Deck a profile, and so you can set it up. I have some fun profiles here from a company called Sideshow FX. I'll link those in the bio, and you can grab those completely free, and you're going to be able to see here, like, it just runs Pac-Man. Or I've got on here Space Invaders, and then it's going to load Space Invaders too. Sideshow FX has a bunch of custom made buttons and actions that you can buy, and you might want to check them out if you're like, man, this looks like too much. I'm just looking for something pretty simple. That may be the way to go. Load my default profile of how I want to use it. Now, you could easily set up profiles for, maybe you have one profile for work, so it has something like Zoom, or it has the websites you use. And so I've linked a lot of my day job stuff. Basically, we have this set up here, and inside of this, you can click on an icon. Let's go ahead and start a fresh page. It's going to look like this as it's fresh. And you walk through multiple actions. So if you want something to, I want to, load this program and then start a new video. And then I want this, it's going to load all of that. And so you could have one button that starts, I'm going to have it load QuickTime. Then I'm going to have it start a new video, turn on my lights, and start recording all from a quick click of the button, as long as there's a shortcut key attached to it. So you can navigate however you want to do that. Soundboard options, Stream Deck options, Stream Labs. So if you have, you can set up different scenes, things like that, especially if you're using Elgato's lights and their camera, there's a lot more functionality that you can use inside of this. So mostly it's inside of the system that I use. And so we could have it go to a website. So let's just say we want to title it that we're going to go to Facebook. And so we could load Facebook, and then we're going to type in the URL or just copy and paste it right there. And now it's going to do that. Now, getting requests in the background would mean that it would load the request and not load a web screen. This is going to load our browser when we hit that. So we want to make sure that that's on. You can also remove the title, and so it's going to show up just like that. If you want to do a custom icon, you can get it from a file. So you could download any kind of PNG file, a GIF or GIF, however you want to say it, as well as a WebP format now that you can put in there, anything that's motion that's moving on there. So what I've done is kind of cultivated from the internet a bunch of different files. I've also made some of my own inside of Final Cut Pro, and then I set those as a set file, and I bring those and I set those inside of my icon. And so I have them all right here that I've stored, all the different ones that I might use for whatever thing. So I have a Facebook GIF right there that I created. I'll hit open, and then you're going to see that it's going to attach it right there. And so now if you look over onto the actual Stream Deck, you're going to see that it's moving right there. Kind of cool that it's set up. So you can set up a hotkey switch, lights on, lights off. And so you're just going to click it, and then it's going to say observing keystrokes, and then you're just going to do whatever keystrokes you want. I have it set up inside of Zoom, and then I have here, this is going to load Zoom. This is my mic, and notice here, this is the hotkey switch, key one, key two, and it's going to switch back and forth, and I've assigned two icons, the mic on and the mic muted. And so I can jump back and forth. I've done the same with the camera, camera on, camera off. That's going to give you a really quick visual look at just down at your desk, because it's going to change colors based on whether it's active or not. These here will just load the app. You can drop open in this rocket ship here and drop the rocket ship. And then you can just choose the program that you want to load inside of there. It's going to open your applications. What do you want to load? And let's say we want it to load Final Cut Pro. So now it's going to go. Now it gives you the basic icon that they have, but Elgato's got a bunch of ones as well that you can do. Create a new icon through their library, open the Stream Deck icon library. It looks like this. And then you could see if you can find one on there. So if you're interested in Spotify, you can set up play and pause right there and have it loaded out. My page here, I have it set up to load different things that I might use from time to time. So, and then I also have a wallpaper there. You can create a wallpaper and then individually assign each one of these pictures. It's going to take a little bit, but that's the wallpaper. And then in behind here, I have assigned to jump to different pages. If I'm on that page two, because this is page one, three, four, five, it jumps down below. And then I usually keep my bottom two right and left buttons so that I can go to the next page. And this first one here is going to actually turn on my studio lights. So there's a whole Stream Deck store that you can look at the different models that they have. They have Stream Deck Plus, which is a new one that comes with dials and actions on it, as well as the Stream Deck XL, which has 32 customizable buttons. Really just depends on what you might need at the touch of your fingers and whether or not you want to scroll a page or not. So again, the limits to customization is really dependent on you and your imagination and what you want to do. I hope you found this helpful. I'm Robbie. If this has been helpful for you, leave a comment, like, and subscribe. We'll see you next time.